My name is Jennifer Stuckey, and I'm here doing one of the first live videos I've ever done. I've done a couple of them before, but full disclosure, this is like maybe my third time doing a live video, and I'm using software that I have never used before. I've kind of played around with it a little bit. So hopefully all of this will go out really well, and everyone who wants to see this video, it will be there. It's supposed to be on YouTube, my channel, Wooden Singer. It's also supposed to be on my Facebook group, and also it should be on the Oboe Studio, the University of Wyoming. So hopefully it's going out to where it's supposed to. So if you have any suggestions and there's weird things going on, just let me know. Okay, so today I'm beginning kind of a new thing with reed making. I'm going to try and do more live reed making videos in the future. This is the first one, obviously, that I'm doing in a while after back from maternity leave. So bear with me here. And I wanted to talk about I know it's not really like what you would think about starting with, but I wanted to talk about fixing a spreading sound on your oboe reeds. So I have some reeds that I made at a different elevation when I was in Wyoming. I'm in Colorado now, so I'm a completely different elevation. I haven't played a lot since I've been up there, so they might be a little bit weird, but I've got three different reeds, and I want to talk about what we can do to control a spreading sound, because it's actually a deceptive thing that's happening that happens with your reeds. All right, so the first thing that I want to talk about is, first of all, that it's tricky. It's a tricky problem to fix because what ends up happening is that we don't actually think we're controlling the reed, but we are. So, and that's usually where part of the problem is. So let's see, this reed kind of, I tried this reed out and it spreads just a little bit. So let me just play it for you. So the biggest problem with this reed is that it's flat, but it also spreads. And that's what I want to talk about. So the first thing to fix when you have a reed that's spreading is that there's two problems. The first one is that it's probably just a little bit flat. So I'm gonna take and crow my reed. And that's the first thing I want to fix. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch here so you can see what I'm doing. All right. Okay, so here's my reed right here that I have, and this reed is flat. We'll talk about how to crow a reed some other day, but it's really important to know how to crow a reed because sometimes reeds can be, the crow can be a little bit deceptive as well if you don't know how to crow it properly. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and clip this reed just a little bit. It's a little bit flat and hard. It has been over soaking just a little bit, soaking too long. So if you can see what I'm doing, I'm gonna go ahead and clip that. And I just clipped just the very, very little bit. Like, I don't know if you can even see. That's all I clipped. Just because just a little clip like that can usually fix many problems. Okay, that brought it up. So that's the first thing to do to fix a spreading sound is to make sure that it's up to pitch. All right. Actually sounds pretty good to me, but I can hear that the sound wants to spread a little bit, especially in certain notes. You can hear it on the C. I don't know if you can hear that, but compared to the from the B flat to the C, you see how that C really sticks out? That's the reed spreading. Now, one of the things to do to check that. Okay, let me back up just a little bit. Got to back myself up. The thing to do is when you're playing sharp, so we're talking about a spreading sound and playing sharp, very often is because the reed is flat and out of control. So I'm going to check that and see what's going on without using my embouchure. Because what happens is we use our embouchure to overcompensate. And the way to do that is to check like this. Right out of the side of your mouth, you can check that. So, it's still pretty much crowing in tune. It's just a hair flat, so I'm still going to fix that. Make sure. There you go. I'm laughing because I can't figure out how to move this. All right, there we go. Oh my goodness, the camera is really weird. Okay, this is hilarious. All right, that's good enough. Let me go ahead and clip that. So again, just a little hair to clip. That's all I clipped. Okay. Okay, the reed is still spreading. So now let me show you what I'm going to do next. I'm going to grab a plaque out of here. Okay, so the first thing to do, a spreading sound is complicated. Let me just sum this up for you guys. A spreading sound is complicated, number one, because most likely it's a little bit flat, but we're trying to control it with our embouchure. Second of all, so that's why it's a little bit tricky. And then the other place, once I get the reed up to pitch, I'm actually going to check, there's a place I want to check on my reed. Let's make sure it's looking really good. And that is, let me grab my pointer. That's going to be right along the sides of the heart. Now you can see, can you see, this is the rail right here for anyone who doesn't know what the rail is. Can you see that the rail goes all the way up into the heart, almost all the way to the tip? What we want to do is we want this rail to fade into the heart. We don't want it to go all the way through the heart. So I'm actually going to take that little sliver off. And sometimes if the rail might not look like it's still there, but there's still some thickness here that's thicker than here. So we want the heart to have an even, we want it to be even all the way across here. And if you leave a spine in your heart, that's fine, which I do. I leave the spine going through my heart. But what we want to make sure is that this doesn't actually get thicker. We want it to fade into the heart. So, and I can see there's just a little bit of thickness right there. I'm going to go ahead and take that off. Couple of scrapes. That's it. And this one has just a little bit. I don't know if you can see it. Whoops, you can't see it. Right there. Just like a couple of scrapes. That's it. All I'm going to do. And that made a really big difference. However, it lowered the crow a little bit, so I'm going to go ahead and fix that. And again, that's all I clipped, very, very little. Better. I don't know if you can hear the difference, but let's just play. I'm going to play the C and the B for you to hear that difference. And that's much better. There's still a little bit of shrillness between the C and the B. The C is a little bit more shrill than the B, and that's how I can usually check. But it's actually not bad. and it's a little bit of an improvement as well. So those are the two things that I do to fix a spreading sound. First, make sure that your read is up to pitch. That's deceptive because sometimes a sharp read will actually be low. That won't be up to pitch. So you have to double check by making sure that you're playing off the side, off of the side of your mouth. And then you need to go ahead and so double check your crow, make sure you're crowing it accurately, clip it up to pitch, and then double check the sides of your hearts to make sure that they're not too thick. So that is it for today. I hope that was helpful. Let me know about the comments, and I apologize for my brain fog. I will get better the more that I keep doing this. So thank you for watching, and hope you have a nice night. Bye.